Hey, hello, it's me, Paul. Well, we're on our second missionary journey. That is myself and Silas, also Timothy and Luke. And we were in a city called Philippi. And let me tell you about what happened in Philippi. Well, we had been down to the place of prayer by a river where we had met Lydia, told her about Jesus, baptized her. Well, another time we were going to this place of prayer, and we were met by this slave girl, this poor slave girl. And she had this evil spirit, and she had evidently this ability to tell fortunes. But since she was a slave girl, she was owned by someone else. So she actually told fortunes, and others made money off of her. That was a terrible thing. Well, anyway, she kept following us, and she got to be annoying. And so I've decided to help this girl. And so I turned around and I said to her, in the name of Jesus, I told the spirit to get out of her. And the spirit did get out of her, where she no longer could tell fortunes. And so she was in a better place. But also her owners were very upset with us because when she couldn't tell fortunes, she couldn't make money for them. And so they got very angry. And so they grabbed us and they called the city officials. And the city officials came and took us, and they beat us with rods, and it hurt. And we were left bruised and bleeding, and they put us into prison, and they told this jailer to watch over us and make sure we didn't escape. And so they put us in the innermost part of the jail, and they put our feet in stocks, that is where our feet couldn't move, and they put chains around our wrists. And there were other prisoners in there. And we started singing. We started singing to God. We started praying to God. Even though that we had been beaten, even though that we were hurting and bruised, we knew that God still loved us, that God was still with us, and that God still had a mission for us that we needed to do. And so we were singing, "Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice." Singing songs like that, and all the prisoners were listening to us. They never heard anything like this. They never saw anything like this. So we were very different than they were. And so we were singing and praying, and about midnight, there was this big earthquake. Everything started shaking. The rocks began to fall down. There's smoke that came up and dust came up. The jail door broke open. Our chains fell off of our hands, and the stocks came open over our feet. And the jailer, who was supposed to be guarding us, woke up. He was asleep, and he thought we'd escaped. And he was scared, because when you were guarding a prisoner, you were told, don't let them escape, because if you let them escape, we would have to kill you. And so he thought that since we were gone, so he began to kill himself. And before he could do that, I yelled out, "Don't hurt yourself. We're all here still. No one has escaped." So the jailer comes rushing into the prison where we all were. And he falls down, and he is scared. He's frightened, and he says to me and to Silas, he goes, "What am I going to do? I need help. I need you to tell me what I'm supposed to do." And so we began to tell him about Jesus. And so he took us to his house, and we continued to talk about Jesus. And that same hour of the night, he and his whole household was baptized. And he took care of us. He bandaged our wounds. He fed us. And the next morning, the city officials sent the police down to tell us to quietly get out of town. But I said, no. No, they need to come down here themselves, because, you know, we are Roman citizens, and it's against the law to beat a Roman citizen without a trial, and they beat us. And so they came down, and they apologized to us like they should, because they were scared, because they might get in trouble from their bosses, and they told us to please leave. Well, so we left the jail, and we went back to Lydia's house for a while, and she fed us and took care of us, and then when we were ready, we left town. But we left the jailer there as a believer, and he was rejoicing. And we were teaching him that he could rejoice even when things are not great. So whether things are going great or where things are not going so great, you can still rejoice in God. You can still have joy because God still loves you, and you still have hope in God. So that's my story about what happened in Philippi. And we continue on in our journey, but I'll have to tell you another part of the story later on. So bye for now.